So dear students, today we are going to discuss about cerebrum. So before going to the cerebrum, we should know what is meant by nervous system. Nervous system, which includes the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system means it includes the brain and the spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system means the nerves arising from the brain and the spinal cord. Those nerves together known as peripheral, or those nerves belongs to the peripheral nervous system. So nervous system means it includes the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system means this brain and the spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system, those nerves arising from the brain and the spinal cord. So that is what the nervous system. So now we are going to discuss about the central nervous system, which includes the brain and the spinal cord. See, first brain. What are the parts of the brain? See, brain, it is having forebrain, then midbrain, and hindbrain. Forebrain means it includes the cerebrum. Then thalamus, hypothalamus, subthalamus, metathalamus, etc. Then this connecting part, which is what the midbrain. Then hindbrain, which includes pons, medulla, cerebellum. So those are the parts of the brain. Okay, so brain includes forebrain, midbrain, then hindbrain. Okay, today we are going to discuss about this forebrain. Which part of the forebrain? The cerebrum. Okay, so now we are going to the cerebrum. It is having two cerebral hemispheres. See, here in this specimen we can see two cerebral. This is one, the posterior view of the cerebrum, or posterior view of the brain. See, two cerebral hemispheres. See, this is what one cerebral hemisphere. This one is the opposite cerebral hemisphere. These two are connected by the corpus callosum. It is not clear in this specimen. Okay, so anyway, the cerebrum, it includes two cerebral hemispheres connected by corpus callosum. Now we are going to discuss about this cerebral hemisphere. What are the features, or we are going to see what are the features of the cerebral hemisphere. See, external features. Each cerebral hemisphere is having three surfaces: supralateral surface, medial surface, inferior surface. This inferior surface is divided into orbital and tentorial surface. What is meant by that? See the video. See this one. This is just a model. Just a model of this cerebrum. See, cerebrum, here it is having three surfaces. See this surface. This is what the supralateral surface. See, its upper part, which directs upward, and its lateral part, or this part, which directs laterally. So that's why it's known as supralateral surface. Okay, this one is my left hemisphere. Okay, so supralateral surface, and this one is the inferior surface. Okay, inferior surface, it is divided into this area. This is the orbital, and this one is a tentorial. Now this one is a medial surface. Okay, so medial surface, then supralateral surface, inferior surface. See the model. Supralateral surface. See this one. This is my left hemisphere. See, like this left hemisphere. So supralateral, inferior. Inferior is having two parts, orbital and tentorial, by a groove. Two are separated by a groove known as the lateral sulcus. Okay, so orbital surface, tentorial surface of inferior surface, or orbital part and tentorial part of the inferior surface, and this one is a medial surface. So surface are clear. So each cerebral hemisphere is having three surfaces. What are they? Supralateral surface, then medial surface, then inferior surface, which is divided into orbital and tentorial part. Then it is having four borders: supramedial border, infralateral border, medial orbital border, and medial occipital border. We will see that. See, this is our supralateral surface. Already told you. See, this one is a supralateral surface. This supralateral surface is separated from this medial surface. See, this is the medial surface, and this one is the supralateral surface. by a border. See this medial surface, which is separated from the supralateral surface by this prominent border. This border, it is a supramedial border. Medial surface is separated from the supralateral surface. Clear? Medial surface separated from the supralateral surface by this border, supramedial border. Okay, like that. Here, the supralateral surface, which is separated from the inferior surface by this border, known as infralateral border. Infralateral border. Then, this medial surface, see, medial surface, which is separated from this orbital surface. This is a medial surface. This medial surface, which is separated from the orbital surface by this border. Medial orbital border. Like that, the medial surface, which is separated from the tentorial surface by this border, medial occipital border. So medial orbital border and medial occipital border. What is meant by that? Medial surface, which is separated from the orbital surface by this border, it is a medial orbital border. Medial surface separated from the tentorial surface by this border, this is a medial occipital border. So medial orbital border, medial occipital border, supramedial border, and here comes this frontal border, infralateral border. Okay, so the borders are clear. So what are the borders? Supramedial border, which separates the supralateral surface from the medial surface. Then infralateral surface, which separates the supralateral surface from the inferior surface. Then medial orbital separates the medial surface from the orbital surface. Then medial occipital separates the medial surface from the tentorial surface. Then it is having three poles. The cerebral hemisphere is having three poles. What are the three poles? Frontal pole, occipital pole, and temporal pole. We'll see that. Now this anterior most end, I told you this is my left hemisphere. See, like this, my left hemisphere. So this anterior most end, this is the frontal pole, or this is anterior end of the frontal lobe. This posterior most end, this is the occipital pole, and this end, this is the temporal pole. So anterior end or anterior end of the frontal lobe, this area, this is the frontal lobe. This area, this is a parietal lobe. This area, this is the occipital lobe, and this area here, this area, this is the temporal lobe. Now we can say that anterior end of the frontal lobe, that is what, the frontal pole. Posterior end of the occipital lobe. See, this is the occipital lobe. So posterior end of the occipital lobe, that is what, the occipital pole. Then anterior end of this temporal lobe, this one is a temporal pole. So this supralateral surface here. This is the supralateral surface, and then here we can see the frontal lobe. Okay, and anterior end of the frontal lobe, that is what, the frontal pole. This is the occipital lobe. So posterior end of the occipital lobe, that is the occipital pole. Then anterior end of temporal lobe, that is a temporal pole. So three poles are clear. Then it is having four lobes. Frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe, and temporal lobe. Now we saw, even though we'll see it again. See, this area, this is a frontal lobe. See, this area, this is a parietal lobe. And this area, this is a occipital lobe, or posterior part, that is what, the occipital lobe. Then inferiorly, this area, this is the temporal lobe. So temporal, frontal, occipital, and parietal. So those are the four lobes of this cerebrum, and these boundaries of these lobes are clearly seen only in the supralateral surface. Okay, now we have to see the boundaries. Before going to the boundaries, we should know what is meant by sulcus and what is meant by gyrus. Sulcus means nothing but the grooves. Okay, sulci means nothing but the grooves. Okay, gyri means the elevated area seen between two adjacent sulcus. See here, here in this diagram, you can see numerous grooves. See, another one. Okay, third one. So numerous grooves are there. Those grooves are known as what, sulcus. Now between two adjacent sulcus, see between these two sulcus, there we can see one elevated area. Okay, now the tip of the cursor is on that elevated area known as the gyrus. Okay, so sulcus means nothing but the groove, and the gyrus means the elevated area seen between two adjacent sulcus. Okay, so this one is a gyrus. Sulcus, the here we can see the sulcus, here another sulcus. So between these two grooves or sulcus, this elevated area, that is what the gyrus. So what are the different types of sulci? The first one is limiting sulci, which separates two functional areas at its floor. Then another one is axial sulcus, which is seen in the growing areas. Then another one is opercular sulcus or operculated sulcus, means which separates two functional areas at its lip. And another third functional area which is seen in the depth. Okay, that is what the operculated sulcus. Then next one is secondary sulcus, which is developed because of some other reason, not because of the growth. Then complete sulcus, those sulcus are pretty. Okay, so these are the different types of sulcus. We'll discuss the details later. Okay, so anyway, these are the sulcus: limiting sulcus, axial sulcus, operculated sulcus, secondary sulcus, and complete sulcus. Now we'll move to now the sulci and gyri. What is meant by sulcus and what is meant by gyri? That point is clear. Now we have to discuss the boundaries of these four lobes. I already told you it is having four lobes: frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe, and temporal lobe. So now we are going to see the boundaries. Okay, so in order to identify the boundaries, first we have to identify four landmarks. What are the four landmarks? One is the central sulcus, the other one is the lateral sulcus, then the third one is the parieto occipital sulcus, then preoccipital nodes. Actually, the second point is the posterior rams of lateral sulcus, or posterior rams means branch. So posterior branch or posterior rams of lateral sulcus. So these are the landmarks: the central sulcus, then posterior rams of lateral sulcus, then parieto occipital sulcus, then preoccipital nodes. So first we have to identify the central sulcus. I already told you these boundaries are clearly seen only in the supralateral surface. So we have to search there in the supralateral surface for these four landmarks. So I told you, so it is having three surfaces. This is a supralateral surface, supralateral surface, then inferior surface, then the medial surface. Okay, so here, see here almost towards the middle of this surface, there we can see a groove. See this groove, this is what the central sulcus. Okay, now here we already saw the lateral sulcus, okay, which separates the orbital surface from the tendorial surface. See, this is the orbital surface and this one is a tendorial surface. So this separating groove, okay, see this now my fingertip is on that groove. Okay, so this groove, this is what the lateral sulcus. This lateral sulcus, posteriorly it continues as another sulcus. It is the posterior ramus or posterior branch of this lateral sulcus, or nothing but the posterior continuation of this lateral sulcus. This is the lateral sulcus. This lateral sulcus here posteriorly continues as posterior ramus. Okay, so anyway, this is what the central sulcus, and this one is a posterior ramus of lateral sulcus. Then here, posterior towards the posterior part of the supralateral surface, see here we can see a small sulcus. This one is a parieto occipital sulcus. Parieto, of between the parietal lobe and occipital lobe, that's why it's known as parieto occipital sulcus. Then another point, preoccipital notch. What is that preoccipital notch? See, this is the occipital lobe. In front of the occipital lobe, here we can see a notch or a depression. See, this notch, this is what the preoccipital notch. This border, it is not straight. See, here it is having a notch. Okay, now this notch, this is which is seen in front of the occipital pole or occipital lobe, this is what the preoccipital notch. Now, four landmarks are clear. See, this one is a central sulcus, and this one, posterior ramus of lateral sulcus. this one preoccipital notch, and this one parieto-occipital sulcus. Now we are going to see the, so four landmarks are clear. Now we are going to see the boundaries. First, I am going to draw an imaginary line from this parieto-occipital sulcus to this preoccipital notch like this. Now, behind that, this area, this is what the occipital lobe. Now the boundary of the occipital lobe is clear. See, I'm drawing an imaginary line from this parieto-occipital sulcus to preoccipital notch, like this, imaginary line. Now, the area which is seen behind that imaginary line, that is what the occipital lobe. Like that, another imaginary line, which is extending from this central sulcus to posterior ramus of lateral sulcus. See here, I am drawing a small imaginary line here. Now, in front of that, means in front of the central sulcus and that second imaginary line, see here, we can see the frontal lobe. So, central sulcus and imaginary line extending from the central sulcus to lateral, posterior ramus of lateral sulcus. This area, this is what the frontal lobe. Okay, then third imaginary line from this posterior end to the first imaginary line. Okay, first imaginary line extending from this parieto-occipital sulcus to preoccipital notch, like this. Okay, now the third imaginary line from this posterior end to the first imaginary line, like this. Above that, that is a parietal lobe. Below that, that is the temporal lobe. Now the boundaries are clear. Okay, so these are the just introduction point about the cerebral hemisphere. So each cerebral hemisphere, what are the points? Each cerebral hemisphere is having three surfaces. What are the three surfaces? Supralateral, medial, inferior, which is we want to orbital and tentorial surface. Then four borders, supramedial border, infralateral border, medial orbital and medial occipital border. Then three poles, frontal pole, occipital pole and temporal pole. Then four borders, frontal, parietal, occipital and temporal. Its boundaries. Before going to the boundary, what is Mumbai sulci and what is Mumbai gyri? Sulci means groove, gyri means that elevated area. What are the different types of sulcus? Limiting sulcus, axial sulcus, then operculated sulcus, secondary sulcus, complete sulcus. Then boundaries. In order to identify the boundaries, first we have to identify four landmarks: central sulcus, lateral posterior ramus of lateral sulcus, parieto occipital sulcus, preoccipital notch. Then we have to draw some imaginary lines connecting these four landmarks, then we will get the boundaries.